esteemed chairperson, other dignitaries and learned scholars, ladies and gentlemen, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Already my title of my paper has been announced, so it is it's not time here to read the whole paper here. So I just put few points before the learning scholars. First one is that if we analyze the socialistic regime, what the socialistic regime provides us, they, on the name of collective welfare, they snatched the and stifled the creativity of an individual and the individual liberty on the name of collective welfare and social welfare. And if we look about the capitalistic regime, and under the capitalistic regime, our individual is so open that he patterns the whole society, and the wealth of the society comes under the few persons, just like we look towards the Indian Indian country. There are a lot of capitalists who are leading the government agencies, and if we look the masses, they are suffering due to this capitalistic regime. I am basically from the Aligarh Muslim University, and I am witnessed of this, that there are thousands of people who lose their lives on the footpaths, they are staying their nights on the footpaths, and we, so-called VVIPs, are lecturing on equality, fraternity and justice under the AC rooms and moving on the AC cars, and we are lecturing on about equality and justice. Just look at them, they are staying their nights on the footpaths of, and they have not sufficient food to eat their babies and all that things. So they are the extremes of socialistic regime and the capitalistic regime. These are the two extremes. I want to put here that the social justice of Islam, which provides equal opportunity, absolute freedom of conscience, complete equality of all humans, and permanent mutual responsibility of society. And in the Quran, Allah says this community is the best community. Ya ayyuhan nas kuntum khayrun ummatin ukhrijat lin nas ta'muruna bil ma'ruf wa tanhauna 'anil munkar. This is the best community which Allah says in the Quran. I here want to conclude my paper with this, that in the current times, application of social justice at practical level is as inevitable as anything for the smooth sustenance of a peaceful human society, which is otherwise at the brink of extinction, provides the unrestrained warfare, hatred, mistrust, materialism, greed and egocentrism. Thank you very much.